the bass and the tweeters make the speakers go to war. Ah, the mighty trumpet brings the freaks out to the floor. The bass and the tweeters make the speakers go to war. Ah, the mighty trumpet brings the freaks out to the floor.
Tell me, where the freaks at? Tell me, where the freaks at? Freaks at.
Tell me where the freaks at.
Are you ready to have some fun?
Yeah.
What's up, everybody? It's E. Dunn
and Mel D.
Oh my God, that was perfect.
Happy Independence Day, everyone.
All right, and today we are going to be making our first baked good item that is not from a box. Goals. We are going to be making the Pioneer Woman's Peach Cobbler because we are all that plus some. Let's go. All right, so what Mel D is going to do... Wait to the camera, Mel D. Okay, so what Mel D is going to do is she is going to peel some peaches, which I'm not going to videotape all that because that's going to take a while. But do you have a peach I can demonstrate peeling?
The peach is in the fridge, and I'm going to use my big bowl. It's important to have a big bowl when you're peeling peaches.
Why is it important?
This is my beautiful Hen Workshops pottery bowl that I got way back in the 90s, and I still love it.
Which one do we use it?
They're both the same. We'll use that stuff to get back that's already open.
Okay. Would you like me to demonstrate how to peel peaches? This recipe calls for 10 peaches, about 10. So it's 8 cups of peaches.
Yeah, first we have to wash them off.
Oh, well, yeah. Hashtag safety.
I like clean peaches.
If you hear any Brandon Walsh in the background, that is because we are watching the Red, White, and Bev Marathon. Let's go. It's great. So far they're showing all the juicy episodes, which is... fantastic.
All the summer beach club episodes, baby. The best episodes ever.
Woo! Hashtag beach club.
How do you peel
Melanie is going to show us in a few moments after she is done washing how to peel the peach, because I thought I knew how, but apparently my ways are terribly incorrect. You do not use a vegetable peeler, which I thought you used. Then I asked if you could do it by hand, which also was not true. You must use a knife. For our younger viewers out there, Okay. Please get
so
parents
to
help.
So we need a scrap bowl to put your scraps in.
All right, we're using a Cracker Barrel container from 2015.
Anything will do.
Well, I mean, if you have chickens, then...
If you have chickens, you need a scrap bowl because they love to eat scraps. This is a beautiful Georgia fuzzy peach. Very tasty. In season, ripe, beautiful, delicious.
You sound like you're trying to be the next Bobby Flay. So, you cut it down the middle, right?
Cut it down the middle.
Right along, like, the butt cheek part.
Yes. Twist. If your peach is ripe, it'll pop right apart.
If not, then honey, you've got an issue.
To eat a peach, I like to keep the skin on. But to make peach cobbler, we peeled the skin off.
I'm getting so into this. I'm so happy.
So we're just going to quickly peel the skin off of the peach.
We're just going to show one, and then we're going to come
back. Yes, because we need 8 cups of peaches.
Which is going to take a long time.
Our video would get horribly boring.
And very long.
And very long if you watched me peel 8 cups of peaches. Oh, another important thing to remember on Independence Day. It's not really ever Independence Day without the annual Old Navy flag shirt.
Woo!
Woo!
Hashtag tradition since 1994.
Traditions. They've been making them since 1994. Our family has been getting them since, I think, 1999. The first ones we got said turn of the century. Our last note said last summer of the century, 1999. So our family's been getting these for 20 years. If you don't have an Old Navy flag shirt.
Not 20 though, 13.
You need to. You need to get one. If you run in today, they're probably on clearance.
And how are you slicing the peaches?
You're going to have to change the angle here. Okay, so we just like quickly slice them like that.
Yeah, and again, for our younger viewers, if you're using a knife, make sure your parent is there to watch, because I might have to make you all sign a release form that we cannot be sued for you trying to make peach cobbler and cutting yourself terribly. Sponsored by Shark Week Band-Aids, which I have on.
No offense, but for all you snowflakes out there, knives are sharp. Use your common sense.
I'm sorry, that was a bull. Whoa, Melanie is getting into this.
Well, you know.
Mother.
We live in the...
Listen. Has to not be biased.
But listen. You can't be a wussy, okay? You can't. People grew up for many, many years.
History lesson also on this Independence Day.
Using knives, using sharp things. Riding lawnmowers, riding without bicycle helmets,
dad had a motorcycle when he was 10.
Using tools, all kinds of things.
I'm being a rebel. Sometimes I don't wear a helmet with my roller skates.
You just have to use common sense.
Immediate
coffee peach. Is hot, knives are sharp.
You don't want that.
Use your brain. You can't sue people for stupid things.
Like that lady that was in the McDonald's drive-thru the one time.
Yes.
And that was before the caution label was on there.
Yes.
And she spilled coffee on herself, and she sued because it was hot. Did you want iced coffee? Maybe you should have specified that.
Correct. Okay, anyway, that's how you peel a peach.
All right, we're going to come back when it's time to assemble. And, well, I guess we have to make the little biscuit dough part, which is very delicious.
The peaches should be the best part with the biscuit dough. Yeah.
All right, we'll be back. So we're back. We have all the peaches cut. Package. A lot of peaches. 8 cups of peaches. And so mom's getting out the butter. So we have salt and baking powder and 2 sugars, because I don't know how much I'll need. And we have gluten-free flour, because we're gluten-free. And almond milk, because we're also dairy-free. And butter. And we eat butter.
Right. It's a dairy thing.
Because butter is mostly fat, so we eat butter. Yeah.
So most people who, or a lot of people who can't eat dairy still do okay with butter. So, anyway, moving on.
Okay. Oh, and we have eggs over here.
Yes. We also have organic free-range eggs. Now, if you have chickens like I do, sometimes you have fresh eggs, you can use those. But Today we're using Trader Joe's. Okay, so added to our beautiful peaches. Look at that, folks. I mean, that is the picture of summer right there.
Yes.
Gorgeous.
Definitely.
Gorgeous. Okay, so we need 1/4 cup of sugar added to those peaches.
Mom, do you like doing videos for the YouTube?
And of course, we're using organic cane sugar because that's what we do. We cook and eat organic. Okay. Don't want to eat those pesty chemicals, you know?
Pesty chemicals, aka the pesticide.
Okay, 1/4 cup of sugar, sprinkle them over the peaches.
Do you want me to toss them?
Not yet. And then we need to add in 2 tablespoons of our flour, which Eva already explained. Gluten-free flour. This is Bob's Red Mill 1-to-1 baking flour. You can use it in your recipe just like you would regular flour. All right, Eva's getting us a tablespoon.
Maybe encourage some people maybe to eat a little healthier.
Oh, wouldn't that be neat?
Yeah.
Maybe we should start a full-time cooking blog. What do you think, folks?
All right, let's give a comment down below.
Give us some feedback here. Should I do a cooking blog?
Yeah. You guys
hey,
can...
never know. Might have a future on the Food Network. Watch right. out, Pioneer
Listen,
Woman.
Listen, to give us feedback, you can either comment, you can DM me on Twitter, @TFergie, or on Instagram, @TeaTimeWithFergieFlamingo_ between all the letters. Not the letters, the words. That'd be a lot of underscores.
Okay, so what we're going to do is we're just going to toss the peaches in the sugar flour combination, and we're going to set them aside while we make the little biscuit dough.
Okay, and we've made this before, and it is so delicious.
It's so delicious.
She also made a caramel apple pie. She made a normal apple pie, but we had like a caramel sauce.
Well, again, it was a Pioneer Woman recipe. Okay, so here's why I could never have a future on the Food Network. It's because I use all of Pioneer Woman's recipes. I love her, and I just use her cookbooks almost every day of my life.
Y'all know how I love, like, Drag Race, you know, stuff like that. See, Melanie is just like that, but with the Pioneer Woman.
Don't do the drag queens. No.
She's not into that.
I'm more the Pioneer Woman type. Chip and Joe. People like
Chocolatey
that.
Chocolatey Chippy Gaines, my boyfriend.
Okay, so here we have the peaches mixed in here with the sugar.
I love how you just like
flour.
Took over the camera. And
so we're just
going to
set that aside.
Now,
so in a separate bowl, we need to make our topping.
Delicious. Oh no!
I'm trying
to dig out
another one of my beautiful Hen Workshop's pottery bowls. Have them
she
in four
also had,
sizes.
We had a yard
really
sale.
I need a bigger one because
no, remember
that one
when
is
we
not
had
big enough.
Remember when we had a yard sale?
Yes.
And you had all those little collectible Hen pottery.
I did.
Hen Workshop baskets.
Oh,
you
lucky
had
there.
So many.
I found the next size. This is the size I really need for this project.
I will start this.
Yes. Had a yard sale.
Combine.
Got rid of a lot of stuff.
I need the cups.
Products.
I need the cup.
Two
again.
Cups. I think it is.
I will dry it out.
This is cool how this thing closes. It's like Velcro. Never seen that before. We use these little scoops. Oh no, I lost it. These little scoops.
I'm gonna snow the camera from you.
Mm-hmm. On your own recipe. Not really your own.
Stick it in here.
The only thing that we have eaten, like made the recipe for, was I made a cauliflower pie once.
Oh, let me tell you, it was delicious.
It had a cheese sauce. Like, we like melted the cheese in the cream and made a cheese sauce, and it had potatoes and carrots and celery and onion.
It was absolutely
cauliflower.
It was like a meat pie, only
there was
no
meat.
It was so
delicious. But I love meat, so whatever.
Didn't we put bacon in it though?
Oh, I think we might have.
Yes, there was bacon. So just picture like a chicken pot pie without the chicken, add cauliflower and bacon. It was so good. And she was only, what?
Like eight.
Like eight. And she made the recipe totally from scratch.
Oh, I put too much in.
It was fantastic.
Jeez, gosh darn it. This is why I don't bake.
Okay, wait a second.
This is why I use a box. You dump it in, add an egg, and you whisk it, and you put it in the oven. And it comes out magical, delicious food. I'm a terrible baker. Like, I can't do it. Chloe's the scratch baker. She can do, she made a red velvet cake that was very delicious. And she put swirlies all over it. And she made cupcakes once, the blueberry, which they had blueberry yogurt in them. And they had yogurt and frosting. Oh, and they had fresh blueberries, like wild blueberries. Oh my god, it was so good. And then she took it to dance class and all her friends licked, some of them didn't even lick the icing off and they threw them out.
Which, this is why, folks, you need to cook at home. You need to use fresh ingredients, you need to get your kids involved, because if you don't start teaching them to eat healthy when
then
they're
they
little,
go, then
they don't want
not.
To do it. They get used to the taste of that crappy food that most people eat, and then they won't eat healthy. Then they refuse to eat good food.
Like salads, so. I go to Panera and I get salads. Like, most kids my age won't touch lettuce. My brother, this is a funny story about how different we are, because we did not eat organic when my brother and my older sister were little, and I wasn't even born yet. But did you guys go to Eaton Park when you ordered the mac and cheese?
Wait, is this the story about the parsley?
Yes.
Yes.
So they went to Eaton Park.
Tablespoon of baking powder, yes, folks.
They went to Eaton Park and ordered mac and cheese, you know, and they had a sprig of parsley on it, and my brother said, "What is this? I didn't order salad."
He really did. He thought the parsley was salad. It was so funny.
But that's just
hi, Luke, if you're watching. Funny story about you.
Woo! We always tell funny stories on this channel.
Okay.
Trying to do real life things.
Then we need more sugar in the biscuit dough. So
why do we need sugar? We're so sweet.
We need, well, yeah. That's a matter of opinion.
No! What?
No, I'm talking about other people. Not everybody likes us, but that's okay. Because we're just honest, real, and that's who we are. Hey, it's all good.
We're like Val from season 90210. Honest. We say what's on our minds, which sometimes is good. Sometimes
always important to be honest, folks.
You're never gonna make real friends. Let's see if here. You
then
are
we need
yourself.
A quarter teaspoon of salt.
This is fresh sea salt. Like they sent scuba divers to the ocean and they collected each little grain and put it in a small bucket and carried it up and they put it in little jars and they sold it at Trader Joe's because they are all that.
Hey, also, you know what?
That probably didn't actually happen.
Little comment on salt here. I was raised on Morton's iodized salt. Table salt. Processed
not,
salt.
That's not real salt. I mean, it is salt, but it's not like...
It's not good for you.
I'm sure I can eat
it. Do your research on salt, folks. Sea salt? That's where it's at. Especially good.
Eva, get the pink Himalayan.
For recipes, I use this, but... For everyday seasoning, pink Himalayan sea salt crystals.
Do you know how they got this Himalayan sea salt? This are you ready? You want to hear another
good
story?
Stuff.
You guys
want to
hear how they get it? You got the list. This is how they get it. They send these skilled rock salt pickers with little tiny axes like this big, and they pick the little salt off into a bucket, and they sell it at Trader Joe's. There's a lot of buckets to use.
Okay, so here we go. We've got our dry ingredients. We're using our little pastry blender because we're going to need it in a few minutes to add the butter. For right now, we're just going to mix our dry ingredients together. You don't have to cut it yet because there's no butter in there yet. Just kind of swirl it around a little bit.
Swirl it around.
All right. We're just, yeah, just so the dry ingredients are mixed, we're going to put this stuff away. Get everything out of our way. Oh, and at this point in time, since we're getting near done, we can preheat our oven to 425.
Y'all can follow him if you want. I always remind the viewers they are welcome to follow along with the recipes at home.
Okay, so now the next thing we need to do. We need to get a stick of butter. Mm-hmm. This is our Trader Joe's quarters here, a half a cup. We're going to cut it into pieces and put it into our biscuit batter.
The biscuit dough, so delish.
Biscuit dough is one of the most amazing things in the world. And we're just going to take these little slices
but also
and
you
put
cannot...
it into our biscuit dough.
Listen, if y'all are looking for a shortcut, Mom, you're going to hate me. If y'all are trying to make this in a shorter amount of time, then I'm like, you might need to go to the store and get some pre-made biscuit dough. Not gonna be as good, promise you that. If you're looking for a time crunch, though,
I would say if you're not gonna make it from scratch, don't bother, because you're just cheating yourself.
This is the real news.
Once you start eating real food, all that pre-made stuff tastes like crap.
No, like, see, I was at my grandparents' house the other day, and they had, like, the Pillsbury biscuits, you know? And I ate it, and I was like, what is this? And they're like, it's a biscuit. I'm like, that's not a biscuit. That's, like, cardboard. It tasted...
Okay, so here's the fun part, folks. The pastry cutter. This little tool. It's so much fun.
Well,
so you just cut the butter into the flour
It also
mixture.
Kind of gets annoying when the butter gets all clunked up in
it's
there.
It's so much fun.
Melanie also thinks a lot of things are fun that are not. Like long road trips. Those are
I love long road trips. They're so much fun.
She likes to sit there and hum to the radio, which drives
I
everybody
do.
Bananas.
True.
Because it's not like...
Nothing like being in a vehicle, driving down the highway, seeing America. It's wonderful. God bless
Listen,
America.
I don't have
we
any...
live in a beautiful country. The most lovely country in the world.
I mean,
the best place in the world to live. We are so blessed. Just saying.
I eventually want to live in Australia, though, so no offense to America. Hashtag, sorry. Hashtag my apologies. Hashtag big sharks live in Australia, but that's okay. Big sharks. Also sponsored by the Shark Week Band-Aids. Shout out number two. My dad has a blister on the back of his foot, and it's like a good size. It's like the size of my thumbnail blister, probably even bigger than that. And he needed a Band-Aid, you know? And we have like normal Band-Aids, but I was like, let's shake this up a little. So I came down from my room, because I have these stashed in my room, with this Band-Aid that has this great big great white shark on it, and it says Shark Week, and I was like, this'll suit him well. So now he's sitting at a parade with this Shark Week Band-Aid visible on his ankle, so.
And who doesn't love Shark Week?
That is also a fact. Most people don't like Shark Week, and I'm like, you people.
Well, you know, Shark Week has been around for a long time, so somebody.
I like Shark After Dark. I like that talk show they do, like, after the day is over.
They recap all the shows, all the
shows. Right, and I know, and Dad doesn't like it, but I like when
they talk about it. Okay, let me take a look at this and see how it's coming along here. Eva's doing a great job here cutting the butter into the flour mixture. See how fun that is, folks?
So fun. Keep,
and you know what? It's good. It's a good workout for your arm.
Who needs work gym those arm muscles when you've got a pastry blender?
That is true.
Like, very, very seriously. Look at Brandon, the cabana boy. God bless him. Oh, that's not Brandon. That's some old lady. Oh, geez. My apologies if Jason Priestley is walking. Walking? Watching.
How about that? Red, White, and Bev. The Beverly Hills 90210 Marathon on the 4th of July. Summertime beach episodes. It's just so lovely.
Well, let me get which
all in preparation for August 7th. You know what that is, folks?
Probably not.
The premiere of the new Beverly Hills 90210.
I think it's called BH90210.
I don't know, but I'm excited to see it.
Are they going to count this as like season 11?
No, I don't think so.
No, see, I think that's rigged. Because if it's the same people with the same storyline.
So, give us your feedback, folks. What all was your favorite episode of Beverly Hills 90210? Who's your favorite character? Dylan McKay, he was mine. Luke Perry, God rest his soul.
Oh, see, I'm going to have to disagree.
Really?
Mine's either, I love Brandon, love him. And I really, Donna in the later seasons, she like went from not like, she went from like goofball, kind of stupid,
yes,
to like the one, yeah, who had the best. Like, if you needed somebody there for you, Donna was always there because Donna Martin, what a gem.
Honestly, I like all the characters. Love that show. My favorite show of all time.
See, I just now started,
hands down.
It used
never
to be,
been a better
used
show.
Used to be Full House. I have like all the seasons, and I used to watch it.
Okay, so what we're gonna do? We're gonna take our little glass measuring cup. We're gonna measure out a half a cup of milk, almond milk, unsweetened. All right.
Unsweetened original, not unsweetened vanilla.
Yeah, no, not gotta watch that because sometimes I might accidentally buy the vanilla, and then that's just gonna throw you off because it's gonna give everything you make a vanilla flavor, and you don't necessarily want.
Mom, that. You had exactly a half cup.
I think doesn't it need like a tiny splash more?
No. You're like right on the line.
Yeah, sure.
I think it's like right on the line.
Just no, come down here. It's like a tick more.
I think you're a tick off. Sorry.
Not to be confused with ticked off.
This is family
okay,
programming.
Perfect. Yes, we'll end it right there because this is suitable for the entire family. Whoa, stop. We have to mix in the egg to that.
Oh,
all right.
I
so
apologize.
Eva, can you find our whisk?
I will try.
Okay, so we're gonna use this lovely free-range organic brown egg. Crack it, and we're gonna whisk those two items together.
Just one.
Go
egg.
Go ahead, Eva. Whisk away, baby.
Look at me with these fabulous whisking skills. I'm like the pastry blender.
Now, we also want to mention that in this recipe, you don't have to use peaches. You could substitute blueberries, blackberries, Rhubarb. Rhubarb, you could use.
Apples.
Apple cobbler? Maybe.
Well, like, it's kind of like apple crisp.
Yeah, I kind of like the oats with the apple crisp, but also a good choice might be, like Eaton Park has a peach berry pie that I absolutely love, and I have made it myself before, but you could use what they put in the pie. They use a combination of peaches, blueberries, and sweet cherries. It is so good. If you ever go to Eaton Park, you need to get the peach berry pie.
It was good. I like the chai tea milkshakes.
Okay, so she's going to dump in the milk and egg mixture into the flour butter mixture. Okay?
There we go.
And then we're just going to use our handy dandy whisk again, and we're just going to
It's a pastry blender!
Oh, yeah.
Grief. Mom, we should start a band, and we should sing Backstreet Boys, because we love that.
You know, and my best... What was the song I always loved with the whisk?
She always used to sing the Watch Me Whip, Watch Me Nae Nae.
Okay, because a few years ago, Paula Deen was on Dancing with the Stars. And she did a little twist on, what was the name of the song
again? Watch Me. It's called Watch Me Whip. By Celente.
Okay, right? Watch Me Whip, Watch Me Nae Nae.
Yes.
And she, instead of saying Watch Me Whip, she had a mixing bowl in her performance.
She was whipping.
And she said, Watch Me Whisk.
She was whipping cream.
She whipping cream?
Yes.
Okay, well, okay, so she was whipping.
Sweet cheese.
And I just thought it was so funny.
So now,
I love Paula Deen, too. That's Southern women. I like Southern people.
Okay.
They're so sweet. Okay.
Josh from the Cracker Barrel!
Josh from the Cracker Barrel!
Mom had a 25-minute romance with
Josh. No. Wasn't a romance. He was young enough to be my son. No, we were all sitting at the Cracker Barrel in Knoxville, Tennessee.
We've been all over the country.
Our server was a young guy named Josh, and he was just the cutest thing.
Oh no, I just dropped it. Almost dropped it.
I don't know what somebody at our table ordered mashed potatoes. I guess maybe it was me. Was it me?
No, it was Dad.
It was Dad. Okay.
And he got down and he goes, "You want some gravy on them taters?"
On them there taters.
Them there taters. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
And Chloe and I ordered lemonade, and he brought them out in those, like, big beer mugs, and he set them down, and he's like, "Now don't y'all be telling, because I'm giving y'all a little special treat with these big mugs." I was like,
I'm sure he treats all his customers that way.
We need to go back to Knoxville.
Because Southern people are
Josh.
Just so sweet. Listen, we could take a lesson from Southerners.
I'll take this biscuit.
We need to slow down the pace of life and enjoy and be friendlier. Be sweeter. Love everybody.
We all need to take one moment, sit on our porch swings, and take in the beauty of America.
Right. The only thing I don't agree with the Southern people on is the tea. The sweet tea? Oh, gag. It is so disgusting. Unsweet tea.
I tweeted about that the other day. If y'all follow
Can't do the sweet tea.
If y'all follow us on Twitter at T4D. I tweeted
Southern folks, y'all are sweet enough. You don't need all that extra sugar.
I tweeted the other day. Remember when you accidentally bought the sweet tea?
Oh, we went to Qdoba the other day. Listen, I don't know why they did this, but they switched around the unsweet and the sweetened tea containers. I don't know if they do it just to throw people off, to sit back and laugh when they watch people take a drink of that sweet tea and... Oh, it's just terrible. So I took a big old gulp of tea, expecting it to be the delicious tea that I always drink, and
it's not.
Gag. It was disgusting. It was like drinking raw sugar. That's not tea, folks. I like to taste the tea.
Well, so I tweeted, it said, when Qdoba switches up the unsweet with the sweetened tea, and you get the sweet instead of the unsweetened.
So this biscuit dough is gorgeous. Mama. Eva. Hold your camera up there so people can see the beautiful biscuit dough. All right, that is lovely. Okay, so what we need to do, first of all, you need to keep your family away for this part because they keep eating the raw biscuit dough. So if you're not careful, you'll put your peaches in your dish and you go to put the biscuit dough in and you won't have any left. So important to keep them away for this. So we need to get a 2-quart baking dish. So...
This is also the one you put baking. Yes.
Alright,
do you think we should do that, or do you think we should use the longer?
No, this one.
This one? Okay. So what we need to do to this,
here,
I believe...
Here, let's move the biscuit dough out of the way so we can slide that in to the camera.
Okay, I'm just wondering if we need to butter the dish. So Eve, just get a paper towel and put a little bit of butter from the butter dish on there and butter the bottom and the sides of your 2-quart baking dish. Even if it's not in the directions, like she said, what's a little butter going to hurt?
Right, I mean, just butter.
It's going to be delicious. Okay, so Eva is greasing the bottom of and sides of our 2-quart baking dish with some beautiful, this butter here, this is Kerrygold butter.
I love the Kerrygold butter.
Ireland,
all that.
They let their cows graze there. Beautiful.
Okay, y'all hold that up. Y'all can see these peaches. Sweet, cheese, delicious. Is this gonna fit? Yes, it is. All right.
Just barely.
There's two peaches, Mom. Okay. Should we eat them?
Oh, well, you know what? They're left over, so one for you and one for me.
That's what I literally just said.
Ooh. Folks. I wish I could share with y'all through the screen.
Those
peaches are so delicious. Okay, do you want to show the folks what this looks like when it's in the pan?
Yes. So it's going to look like...
So it's just, I kind of just flatten them down a little bit because we're going to get ready and put our biscuit dough on. So now for this, what we're doing next is we're going to tear off pieces of the biscuit dough and we're just going to like plop them down on top of the peaches.
Oh, my piece was too small. Gosh darn it.
Yep, just plop it on there.
This is a great family activity. Like, if you have little kids.
Plopping dough.
Well, make sure they don't think of Play-Doh.
Screams family togetherness, right? But, well, hey. The one thing, if they eat it, it's not going to hurt anything, right?
Play-Doh's non-toxic, so if they eat it, then, like,
whatever. Well, yeah, but it doesn't taste as good as biscuit dough.
Well, remember the one time where we made our, homemade salt dough?
Oh, yeah.
And I ate it? Because I felt like doing it? Being a jerk. Look at all this leftover dough. Just
yeah, you still got it. No. You just got to keep piling it up there till you run out. It's so delicious. It's just gonna be beautiful. I'll tell you, this is one of my favorite summertime recipes. You want to find the recipe? It is in the Pioneer Woman cookbook. It's called A Year of Holidays, and so the cookbook is broken down into sections.
This one is under
for each holiday. This one is under actually 4th of July, right?
Yep.
Oh no, summertime cookout. It's
well,
called.
It says 4th of July down here.
Okay. So peach cobbler. Okay, so you know what? Since there's a lot of biscuit dough on here, Eve and I are just going to share another bite of this because it's just so delicious.
Wait, I'm going to toss it in the air and we're going to see if I can catch it. Okay. Mm. If not, it's going to be a terrible loss. Back up.
I could eat.
No!
Okay. Now that one has dog hair on it.
It's okay.
I could seriously eat.
No!
An entire bowl.
We're done.
An entire bowl of this raw biscuit dough. I could eat it plain.
Not advised by the health.
So delicious. Okay, so that's all there is to that. Then we're going to pop it in the oven.
At 425.
Oh, wait 1 second. Forgot a step. We need a little bit of sugar. You know what? Just dump that salt out. Put a little bit of sugar in there. What we do is we just grab a pinch of sugar, sprinkle it on top of the biscuit dough. So just a tiny, tiny bit.
I'm sorry. This video is really long, but it's worth it. If you watch it till the end, it is worth it.
Hey, 25 minutes of your life to get the best peach cobbler on the planet. Okay, that we don't need that much. But what we're going to do is we're going to take a little sprinkle of salt. And we're just going to sprinkle it around.
I'm going to put some...
Okay, that's good. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's good. Nope. No more. Done. Do not eat raw sugar. Plain sugar. No, we do not do that. That's all there is to it, folks. We're going to pop it in the oven.
And we'll be back when... Oh, there's...
We're going to cover it lightly with foil. Bake it for 30 minutes. Remove the foil. Bake for another 15. We can serve it warm or at room temperature. And the best way to serve it, Eva, go get the ice cream. The best way to serve it, warm, with a little vanilla ice cream. Now, as Eva mentioned, we're dairy free. So we got this so delicious brand, dairy free vanilla ice cream.
So delicious, it's so delicious.
Made with almond milk.
Yes.
It's delicious.
Y'all are allergic to almonds also.
So there you go, folks. You've got a dairy-free, gluten-free peach cobbler with ice cream.
We're going to do a short video when we pop it out of the oven.
Yeah. Also. We'll see you again when it's done.
Yeah.
So enjoy.